Today, we will show you how to do referencing of unpinned MPO cabling using the extension cord method. This process will require a total of 4 cords to conduct and verify the results of your reference. We'll have TRC1, which is unpinned at both ends. A second TRC is pinned at one end and unpinned at the other. As you might have surmised, we also have an extension cord, which is pinned at both ends. And these 3 cords together will represent the testing setup we'll be using in the network testing itself. Finally, because we'll usually want to verify that the complete test assembly is functioning correctly, we'll also include a 4th cord, simulating our cable under test. And like that real-world system, it will be unpinned at both ends. The first step in referencing is to ensure that all of your test cords and all the ports on your testers are clean. For this, we emphasize the inspect before you connect approach using the appropriate inspection scopes and cleaning materials as required. First, fully charge your testers ahead of time, but do make sure your source unit is powered on but disconnected from the power for at least 20 minutes before you begin testing. So to begin, we'll conduct a reference with TRC1. First, we'll connect the 2 units together. And on connection, you'll hear an audible tone to confirm it. So to begin the first reference, we'll kick set reference and go next, and a few seconds later the result will come back. If we're happy with the results, we can select next to store those values and move on to the next stage. So now we'll move on to unplug TRC1 from the meter. I'm going to put the free end into the scope on the source for safekeeping. So taking TRC2 and identifying its unpinned end, I'll connect this into my meter. Before mating it, both TRC1 and TRC2 via a reversed key MPO adapter. Again, here we're going to be listening for an audible tone to confirm they're connected. So exiting briefly, I'm going to make sure that I have chosen an appropriate test profile for this first verification step. So in this case I do, I've made 2, one for this first step and one for the second step. So in this case I'm wanting a loss no greater than 0.35 dB for the 2 TRCs. So we're okay to go ahead with this. So selecting my test to begin with, I'll now initiate it through the screen here. And what I'm looking for is a pass result, but typically I wouldn't save this result at this stage in the process. So that has given me a pass indicating that TRC1 and TRC2 are both good. With both TRCs tested and whilst they're still connected, we're going to set a reference once again. As we did last time, we're going to be looking for good absolute power values again. Okay, so that has given us good results back, so we're ready to continue. So now what we're going to do is we're going to disconnect the TRCs from each other, and we are going to connect the free end of TRC1 into the extension cord using a reversed key adapter. And now that we've got these 3 cords, effectively we have our test assembly complete. But we want to do another verification test to make sure they are all still good. So here we're taking our unpinned cord, We're going to install it in between TRC1 and TRC2 and the extension cord. Again, we will hear an audible tone to show that the units are communicating once again. And the first thing we're going to do before we do this test is we're going to just go back out to the home menu and we're going to choose a different profile. So I've set two profiles and this second one is going to take into account the new loss values we expect to get when we're testing these test chords together. So I'm going to start my test. I'm going to choose the first of my reference verification labels for the project. And now I can go ahead and trigger my test. So that has come back with a passed result, showing me I'm good for polarity. Both wavelengths are being tested are good in terms of margin. And I can also see things like my length values as well. So I'm good to go ahead and save this reference verification value, this label, and begin my production testing. So that was an overview of how you set up and reference your MPOLx loss testing kit in advance of beginning your project.